Hello everybody, welcome to the Java example section. In this section, I'm going to set up a restaurant bill system. My idea is like this. I would create a bill object, and then the bill object will contain the food ordered, the quantity, and the price of the food. And I will get the order and the total cost of the bill by creating some methods. And in this process, I'm going to use some ArrayList to record the order. Okay, let us see the implementation of the bill class first. Since I'm going to use ArrayList, I need to import the ArrayList library beforehand. Okay, and now I can create the instance variables for the bill class. Now I create an ArrayList that stores string references that represent the ordered food string objects. Okay. Then I create an ArrayList of integer objects that represent the quantities of the food ordered. Here I create the constructor for my bill class. When we set up the instance variables on the two rows here, the objects are not yet created. I mean, the ArrayList objects are not yet created because I haven't used the new keyword or the reserved word to set the ArrayList objects. Now I can do so. So the ArrayList that stores the string references for the ordered food is now created when the bill object is constructed in the driver program. I will do the same thing for the reference variable called ordered quantity. Now it points to an ArrayList of integer references. Okay. Integer here is an object type, not a primitive type. I also need an instance variable for the bill to remember the total cost for the bill. Here I set up the getTotal method that returns the total cost of the bill. Now I create the method to set up my bill. I call the method name addOrder. Okay, the method signature is like this. The addOrder method is going to accept the meal. For example, it may be sandwiches or it may be coffee and so on. And for that order, the quantity of the meal mentioned is given in the quantity formal parameter. And here I have two arrays that gives me the dishes provided by the restaurant and the cost of each dish for the restaurant. And when I go back to the driver program, we will be able to understand the meaning of the two arrays. Okay. So let me continue the implementation of the add order method. If I receive a meal from the add order method, I simply put the meal, which is a string reference, into the array list that stores string references, and this array list is the ordered food array list. Okay. When I want to remember the quantity of that meal being ordered, I put the quantity, which is an integer primitive, to the array list called ordered quantity. And here, the auto box action is prepared for us by the Java system. So we don't need to explicitly convert the integer primitive to an integer object before we put it into the ArrayList of integer object references. Okay. I have a for loop now. And what's the purpose of this for loop? Let us see now. Here, I simply match the meal string against the dish array. And if that meal is present in the dish array, I simply pick up the corresponding cost for that dish. And I put this quantity, which is known as the cost for the particular meal, to the equation here. I simply multiply that cost with the quantity ordered, so that I can put the cost for that quantity of meals into the total cost instance variable. Here, I don't need to set up the total cost to be zero before we do use the plus equals operator. The reason is that the total cost instance variable is already initialized to be zero when a build instance is constructed. So that's why we don't need to say total cost equals zero beforehand. Okay, now I can set up the getOrder method in order to print out the order for a particular customer. For this getOrder method, I can do something like this. I loop over all the food mentioned in the ordered food array list. So here, size is simply returning the number of filled elements in the array list that corresponds to the ordered food. Okay. okay, when I traverse the ordered food array list here, I simply get the food in the array list together with the ordered quantity for the particular meal mentioned in the same index called I. Okay, so if I ordered two sandwiches, I simply say sandwiches and then two, which will be the content returned by the getOrder method. And here, the getOrder method is having a return type of void, so it doesn't return a particular value to the driver program. It simply returns the printing result on the console. Okay. So this finishes the build class. So I can go back to the driver program. Before doing so, I save the build.java file. Okay, let me see the error. Oh, I see. The brackets don't match. Before setting up the getOrder method, I need to close the bracket corresponding to the addOrder method first. Okay, and then I can handle the getOrder method. So let me try again. Yes, it can be saved now. Now I go back to the driver program to see what I can do with the build object. As we see from the builds.java file, we need to set up the two arrays that correspond to the dishes and the cost for each of the dishes. So let me do it now in the driver program. Suppose I have sandwich in my dish. I also have coffee. I have French fries. I also have salad. So the array of dish just in the restaurant will be passed to the addOrder method in the build class. Now I set up the cost array that corresponds to the cost of each of the foods mentioned in the dish array. Okay, the dish and the cost are in the same order. Okay, so sandwich would cost $6.5, coffee would cost $3.2, so on and so forth. Okay, now I create a build instance whose reference variable is called my bill. When we call the constructor of the bill class, we would simply create two ArrayList objects. Okay. One ArrayList is storing the ordered food, and the other one is storing the ordered quantity. Now I'm going to pass the copies of the array references corresponding to the dish and the cost to the addOrder method for the build class. okay, when I pass the dish and cost arrays into the addOrder method, this method is able to help us find out the total cost for the whole bill. We will see the answer later. So here I order 2 sandwiches and 2 coffees. I also order 1 set of French fries. I also order 1 set of salad. So the total cost will depend on the value mentioned in the cost array. Now I can call the getOrder method from the bill class. And after that I can return the total cost of that bill. Okay, let me save it and run it. Yes, when I call the getOrder method, I simply print out the order food and the quantities for my bill. And then I would get the total cost of the whole bill as $26.9. Why? When we check against the cost array, we see that 2 sets of sandwiches would cost $13, and 2 sets of coffees would cost $6.4. 1 set of French fries would cost $4, and 1 set of salad would cost $3.5. So altogether, the whole set of bill would cost $26.9. So the idea is complete now. So I hope that you're able to make use of the classes and the methods wisely. In addition, we should be able to create ArrayList objects in constructor. My code is intuitive and straightforward, but it may not be the best or the most efficient approach to a certain problem. If you have any suggestions to improve my code, feel free to do so on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.